All right, okay. So here it goes again. I don't know. I really want to be completely like finished with Divulgences. Like that's it. Like, you know, because herself again and again and again. Her talking about herself, you know. And so now I have to actually, I have to bring it up though because it's humorous. I believe it happens in many cases. It's not just me. I'm not the only. But when you are there on the stage and you have, and you have to dance in an opera, for example, and the opera singer is quite large. Now, if she is quite large, and in my particular case, I was her vision self, her little dream. I had to, in my own respect way, because the dancers are, what are we? We're just nothing to the opera. You know that we're just nothing. We are just like. Years and years and years and years. All the money is you know, it's just the opera can have. But when it comes to the dancers, we're almost just like their little, you know, their shoe kick. You know? And so here I am. I'm like, oh my gosh, she is huge. So she was a really large woman. You know, and there's nothing I could do. She made me eat. I got fatter and fatter and fatter because of her, because I had to dance as her vision self, and so it was the worst thing ever. And so then I'm put into this role, I'm her little soloist self, as if she was a dancer, dancing on a, like this $100,000 stage, and this ridiculous amount of money is talking to this production. And so in respect to her, in reverence to her, I just eat and got fat. And so then I'm like, well, this is terrible. This is absolutely terrible because, like, precedingly after they dangle into my face, well, now you're going to have to dance real ballet. We'll put you in a piece, and you're going to have to wear white. And so I'm like, well, this is okay, fine. It was okay to be fat for the opera. Now this is getting serious because now this is back to hurting myself at ballet. You know? But yeah. I mean. There was no way I could be thinner on stage next to that woman. I just couldn't. It would have been inappropriate. Absolutely inappropriate. So then I don't know what to do with that balance. It's like the actor and the actress, where you have to gain weight for the production, or you have to lose weight for the production. Meanwhile, I had to do both. I had to do the one and the other, and then I have to do this, like, you know, the praise to the goddesses. They're just goddesses of song, you know, because I'm just a lowly dancer. Gosh, dang it, they're amazing. But yeah, so there, that was another divulgence. Yeah. I don't know what to do about the type of stage. That was incredible. It was incredible craftsmanship. Whoever built it, absolutely amazing. But I don't know if she's still alive. You know, it's tough when the women are wearing that much weight. Yeah, very difficult situation. But yeah, so that's another thing. So we're looking over here in such like almost a shallow mentality. I see quite a bit going on in the minds of, oh, this is dance, so you have to be thin. You have to be thin. You have to be thin. Going on, you know, there's a lot of other things going on. When the majority of the money is in the opera, it's about the respect of that particular production, even over any of the plays. I hate to say it, but when it comes to the opera is where the money is. It's where the audience who supports the arts are more so. On the side. We're just something on the side. So, my gosh. Yeah. It would have been awful if I had been some skinny twit out there on the stage for her. Absolutely awful. So I believe I did correctly in being fat for it. So it's kind of interesting. Because in retrospect, he kept He cast both, he got the heavier set of girls, heavier in the ribcage women, me and one other girl, and to dance it, you know, specifically. Already, he already knew the problem. So we have this. Yeah, I don't know. I just think American dancers don't understand. They don't understand that actress has to happen. And yeah, pity the poor born after, because my gosh, that's terrible. That's absolutely terrible. That I have to dance as the mere self to a very large woman, and then go and dance into Bournonville. It wasn't fair to the Bournonville piece, but yeah. So in retrospect, that's life. That's life. Oh my goodness! So that's another funny divulgence, I guess. So all these memoirs. I found the greatest little. I'm gonna show it to you. Hold. My goodness, it's a funny one. I know, I'm so full of myself at the moment, it's fine. But anyway, so this is Harold Christensen. When I was a little child, I'll try to show it to you. Harold. Now he was the founder of the San Francisco Ballet, and he was the founder of, I believe there was another company here, California Ballet, one of the original ballet companies on the West Coast ever. So there he is there, fixing my hand. There I am, very young. And there's another one of him. He was really funny. Actually, he wasn't. He was very dry, humored. He was not a nice man, actually, around people in general. He was quite, what do you call it? A stark conservative personality. But for some reason, he had an adoring self for me. So it's funny. But yeah, there he is fixing me. I love that. Yeah. Really what he was all about. And he was a singular moment to you. You know, he wasn't the type that liked to call it the room at you. He was the type that would go directly at you and deal with you. There are some teachers and choreographers who they yell across the room at you, and there's the others that actually get you up close. And he was great. He was a great master. I think I'm only like, I don't know, 7 or 8 years old there. But it's kind of funny. Master of the dance. So it's fun. It's a fun thing to find, isn't it? And I'm like, gosh, and I'm thinking right now, you know, looking into Russia and the girls as they're chunking up their legs and at the in the line, you know, in the start. I'm like, well, would they have taken me? I mean, proportionately, maybe. Proportionately, I have the good proportions, but they would even want longer legs, and I'm already looking husky there. Probably too many beans and rice, but it's very interesting, because at this point in the age of my life, I'm a jumper. So would that have mattered? Would that have mattered that I was a jumper, or would I have been discontinued? I mean, you know what I mean? They're bringing in these odd little gazellias, you know, and I don't think they're going to have the stamina. Very few are going to have the stamina. So yeah, I don't know. There's nothing wrong with jumping women. Nothing wrong with jumping women. That's all. Roar. What can I say? So through this also, as you bring into the arts, the dance world itself, you know, it's not all about the shadow of being skinny. There's a moment where you actually have to pay your omens of respect to the opera, no matter what. So, yeah.